Lord, what's up?
Going up yonder to be with my Lord. But you know, it takes a lot to get there. Not just by what I do, or by what I say, but who I am in Christ. I'm going to get up yonder. For those of you that have your Bibles with you tonight, turn with us to the gospel recorded by St. Luke, the 14th chapter. Gospel recorded by St. Luke, the 14th chapter. We just want to look at full verses tonight. We're going to start with verse 12. Then said he also to him that invited him, when thou makest a dinner or supper, call not thy friends, I gotta take off these glasses because I still can't see. Call not thy friends, nor thy brother, neither thy kinsmen, nor thy rich neighbors, but that they also might. Lest they also bid thee again, and a recompense be made unto thee. But when thou makest a dinner, call the poor, the maimed, the lame, and the blind, and they shall be blessed, for they cannot recompense thee, for thou shalt be recompensed at the resurrection of the just. And when one of them that sat at meat with them heard these things, he said unto him, blessed is he that shall eat bread in the kingdom of God. Our Father, which are in heaven. Dear Lord, it's once more again that we come to you in the humblest manner that we know how. Lord, we just want to thank you for life, health, and most of all, Lord, we just want to thank you for strength. Thank you, Lord, for this evening, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for those that thought it was not robbery just to come out for the second watch of the evening. And for that, dear cause, Lord Jesus, we just want to say thank you. Ask you, Lord, to bless this service, Lord. Ask you, Lord, to make it the way that you would like it to be, Lord, rather than the way that we would like it to be. For we would like to do all things pleasant in your sight. These and other blessings we ask in our Son Jesus' name, for our sakes. Amen. 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 Good evening to everybody. Now, I know almost everybody that's in. Almost. Some new and some old. But I know just about everybody in here. And everybody considers me to be their friend, correct? Okay, y'all can get quiet on me. Y'all can get quiet on me if y'all want to. Everybody considers me to be the part of their family, correct?
Oh, yeah.
Well, we got a message from y'all tonight. But I got a question for you. You don't have to answer this question. Who is friends and family really for? Is it because this is the only time of the year that we gather together and invite our family, invite our friends to worship with us this evening? Or is it because it's a service that we tell, let people know that you can be a part of God's family and God can be their friend? We're going to talk about the invitation tonight. We're not going to talk about the excuses, the supper that Jesus made. We won't look at the invitation. To my good friend, Pastor Mac, and Sister Mac, to Pastor Lewis, my father, and to all of God's children, we want to use for a subject tonight. It started with an invitation. It started with an invitation. See, Zacchaeus
was a sinner.
Might as well say this microphone. Zacchaeus was a sinner. And Jesus didn't look at who he was. All he saw was a man up a sycamore tree. Why? Because the crowd was in his way. But look at the friends and family. We invite people to come to this service, but we overlook all of God's children. Whether they be a sinner or not, we still overlook them. Whether they know who Jesus is, we still overlook them. Because we want to invite our friends, we want to invite our family, and we want to invite somebody that when the time comes that it's their turn, they know they're going to call us right back. But Jesus said in that 14th chapter of St. Luke, he said, don't just call your friends, your neighbors, and your kinsmen, but call the poor, the maimed, the lame, and the blind. Why? Because the blind just don't know who Jesus is. The maimed don't know who Jesus is. They don't know that the blind man don't know that Jesus can give them their sight back. The maimed don't know that Jesus can cause them to walk again.
That's right.
The invitation. It all starts with an invitation. Why? Because we already decided we're going to have a Friends and Family Day service. The church already decided that. But then once the decision was made to have it on Halloween, then the fact is that the invitations had to be sent out.